Hello, Zero here, and welcome back to Slay the Spire.
Question war elites. Double elites. Might be really risky to do that, but so I have a heal. Yeah, let's go that way. Thievery. It's a looter. Let's see. So I should probably block. So only take 5 damage. Just go with the all-out attack. They're stealing my money. So capacitor won't be useful. Let's just block. That looter won't be long enough to take an effect. So the discard pile is empty, so I won't get any blocks. That's useless. But the enemy's dead now, so he can't block this. There is no way. So 30 gold stolen back, 19 gold, and another card. Static discharge. Whenever you take attack damage, channel 1 lightning. That's okay. Deal 7 damage, draw 3 cards, discard all cards, draw this. This way, that do not cost 0. Oh, drawn this way, that do not cost 0. Oh well. Blizzard deal damage equal to 2 times the frost channeled. This combat to all enemies. Might just go with static discharge. So whenever I take damage, I get one of those orbs. So rest. And the chest. So, Centennial Puzzle. The first time you lose HP each combat. Wait, the first time you lose HP each combat, draw 3 cards. Might just be getting tired, but that didn't sound like normal English. Zap. Yeah, so every time I take damage, use that, then block, block. So that's 1, and that's 2. Now the capacitor becomes really important. Lightning. That's 5 block, that's 5 block. Being a bit too risky with this. Oh, it actually uses it when it goes to the next one. It does. Oh, that's even better. That's way better. And turn. Yeah, so the moment he attacks me, he takes the damage. So ball lightning, sweeping beam, or these things. Whenever you play a power card, draw one card. I think there's a bunch of these with the same title description. So ball lightning will be really useful. Oh, it starts with metallicize. So it always starts with a defense. He's sleeping, so I don't want to attack him yet. Unless that awakes him. It doesn't. Capacitor, static discharge. Don't know if that will be useful. That might wake him up. I think it wakes up on the next one. So let's do zap, ball of lightning, and strike. Now it's awake. But I have 3 of the orbs, so I can deal a lot of damage really quickly. 18 attack, and I don't have any. So let's get that one. And zap, because that was 8 damage instead of 6. And that one does way more. So 18. Another 18. So defend, 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 stack. 93 defense. And at the moment he attacks, he gets damaged. Oh, it's only when I take damage. Doesn't matter. It's gonna die next turn. Minus in strength. So 6 damage plus 8 equals death. So 38 gold, all coins 300 gold, and we have claw. Deal 3 damage, all claw cards. Deal 2 additional damage this combat. Streamline. Deal 15 damage whenever you play this card. Reduce its cost by 1 for this combat. And Blizzard. Deal damage equal to 2 times the frost channeled this combat to all enemies. Oh, orb gains block. Yeah, I haven't seen frost yet. I've only seen the lightning one. So, it's an orb that just gives you defense. I might actually want to use that. That was a bit low. You fall into a puddle. It's made out of slime goop. Frantically, you claw yourself out over several minutes as you feel the goop starting to burn. You can feel goop in your ears, goop in your nose, goop everywhere. Climbing out, you notice that some of your gold is missing. Looking back at the puddle, you see that your missing coins combined with gold from unfortunate adventurers mixed together in the puddle. So yeah, I can't risk 11 damage when I only have 15. So I actually lose gold. You decide that mess is not worth it. Oh, this might be really difficult. I will probably die. So this is an attack. So Blizzard. Zap. Ball of lightning. And that will be useless. Yeah, there's a big chance I die from this one. So, six. Yeah, so I can only attack. But I don't have energy. That deals 6 damage. I'm not gonna use capacitor. So ball of lightning does 7 damage plus 8. Then lock on does 9. Yeah, there's no way I can survive this. Let's try to use this. Invoke you next or 2 times. So 16. And it's dead. 32 golds. And kunai. Every time you play 3 attacks in a single turn, gain 1 dexterity. That's useful. So hologram. Gain 3 block, return a random card from your discard pile to your hand. Agitate or aggregate. Gain energy for every 6 cards in your draw pile. And buffer. Prevent the next time you will lose HP. Oh. So that completely negates an attack. Let's get that one. I can even use it. And another attack. I don't think I can survive an attack. Well, I should still use it. Because I can. Yeah, so they're increasing attack. So that's only 4 block. So defend, defend, and stack. So I'll survive this. So buffer will defend against one of those. Okay, so Blizzard is completely useless without the frost channels. I haven't seen those. So defend does 5 block. Combined with that will make it so I survive. Can't really do much against it. Oh, that doesn't work the way I intended it to. So if it hits your shield, it goes through, it also negates it. That's painful. But I like that character. Let's do that again. I like the defect. Greetings. I brought you back. So merchants. Question mark. Elite. Yeah, so it doesn't. Actually, this might be more battles. But if I go here, merchant, then one of the question marks, then fight him. Let's see. So, won't defend. Oh, I didn't even need to defend. Forget that does like 6 damage. So, zap, defend, defend. Yeah, this might be way better if I had more defense cards. The dual cast, I don't think it's that useful. It also uses up one of the orbs. So I'd rather not. They still do 3 damage passively. Oh, he died. 13 gold. And the cards. Barrage deals 4 damage for each channeled orb. That is useful. Xcape deals 6 damage, invoke your next orb. Reinforced body gains 7 block x times. So this uses energy. So 7 block for all your energy. So put energy value. That might be useful. But so is the barrage. So if you have 4 of them, you deal what, 16 damage? Let's get that one. I have some gold, so. Let's see what he has. Oh, the bronze scales. Actually, this might be way more effective, the toolbox. Let's see, heatsink. Whenever you play a power card, draw 1 card. Reboot, shuffle all of your cards into your draw pile, then draw 5 cards. It exhausts. Skim, draw 3 cards. Streamline, deal 15 damage. Whenever you play this card, reduce its cost by 1 for this combat. Doom and Gloom, deal 10 damage to all enemies. Channel 1 Dark. Oh, that's a new one. Deep Breath, shuffle your discard pile into your draw pile, draw 1 card. Sadistic Nature. Whenever you apply a debuff to an enemy, they take 3 damage. I am gonna take this one, Doom and Gloom. It's an expensive card, but it might be really useful. Let's go around that way. A gremlin is madly shuffling cards on the table. This monster seems to be a harmless one. You approach him out of curiosity. 12 cards, mess them to keep them. 5 tries, no do-overs. Are you ready? Let's start. I'm not good at this. So, zap. And that's a bandage up. Strike injury. Zap, zap. Bandage up, bandage up. Oh, I got really lucky with that last one. You completed the gremlin's game and look up, he disappeared. So I got a bunch. So not a zap. That's probably not that useful unless I have a stupid amount of energy. Bandage up is just speed regeneration. I need capacity for the barrage. Or barrage. That's gonna be way more useful. That's a terrible hand if we're gonna start. For the start. Oh well, cultist. So, Doom and Gloom, 10 damage to all. And I can still use defend. So I get 1 damage and Doom and Gloom. So what does this do, Dark? At the end of turn, increase this orb's damage by 6. Oh. Evoke. Deal 6 damage to the enemy with lowest HP. Oh, so they attack differently as well. So that thing will just become stronger and stronger until we evoke it. So zap, defend and strike. And that's all I can do. Yeah, that one keeps getting stronger. Until you actually use it. So, bend this up. Defend. So, next up will be this one. So, that's 8 damage. And let's just obliterate it. That will peak to 18 damage twice. Gold, dexterity potion, and a card. Beam cell. Deal 3 damage and apply a vulnerable. Melter. Remove all block from an enemy. Deal 8 damage. Cold snap. Deal 6 damage. Channel on frost. So that one gains block. Let's get that one. So before it didn't give me all these different orbs. So 11 damage. Let's do boot sequence. A defend, a zap, and a strike. So that was a full block, so cold snap. Deal 6 damage, channel 1 frost. So that one does at the end of turn gain 2 block, evoke gain 5 block. So let's use that one. And use that. And he's dead. 13 gold, strength potion, and a new card. Hologram, cap 3 block. And turn the cards, stacking block the amount of discard pile, streamline, deal 15 damage whenever you play this card, reduces cost by 1 for this combat. So this 15 damage, well, it's expensive. I'm gonna skip it. So let's fight this thing. Oh, it's this guy again. That's a skill. So cold snap and strike. That's funny because the frost one actually gives me defense. So I can't use that one anymore. Or I'll make it stronger. But this guy's gonna hurt a lot. So that one will work, and then barrage. And 2 block, so there was 12 damage. No, don't use that because then he gets stronger. And all of these are skills, except for the strike. Yeah, so if I heal for 4, he probably gets, what, a bunch of attack? I don't know how much. So strike and barrage. And he dies. So 29 gold, the Vajra. Start each combat with 1 strength. And new card. So capacitor. So gain a slot, orb slot. Storm whenever you play power channel 1 lightning. And impulse. Use the passive effect of all of your channeled orbs exhaust. Let's get capacitor. Especially because of that one card I have. So question mark. You happen upon a group of what looks like purple fire spirits dancing around a large bonfire. The spirits toss small bones and fragments into the fire. which brilliantly erupts each time. As you approach, the spirits will all turn to you, expectantly. Offer, receive a reward based on your offer. So we need to sacrifice something. I might just get rid of Zap. Actually, no, remove one of the strikes. You toss an offering into the bonfire, nothing happens. The spirits seem to be ignoring you now. Disappointing. Well, at least I got rid of a card. So let's just rest. Let's get some of my HP back. And the chest. 27 gold and orichalcum. So 6 block if you don't use a block. So I can go that way. I will actually go that way. So bandage up. Defend, and strike. I could use Doom and Gloom, so I get the Dark Orb. And then just defend once. Unless I can kill one of them, please. So deal 5 damage for each orb. I have 2 of them, so I should be able to kill this. Yeah, I should be using Orichalcum every time right now. And he died. So 16 gold, big potion, and a new card. Thunder Strike, deal 7 damage to a random enemy for each lightning channel. Channel this combat. I'm probably best off with Ball of Lightning. That's Sweeping Beam. There's only 5 damage. And if you use a lot of those orb effects, they just keep running themselves. You walk into a room to find a large hole in the ground. As you approach the hole, an enormous serpent creature appears from within. Ooh, hello, hello. What have we got here? Hello, adventurer. I ask a simple question. The most fulfilling of lives is that in which you can buy anything, do you agree? I keep dying because of this. Disagree. The serpent stares at you with a look of extreme disappointment. I've been killing myself because of that. So, merchant. Well, that might have been really useful. So, let's see what's useful. Let's go for the eye. Deal 3 damage. If the enemy intends to attack, apply 1 weak. Barrage. Deal 4 damage for each channeled orb. Leap, gain 9 block. That's actually really useful. Cool headed. Channel 1 frost, draw a card. Capacitor, gain 1 orb slot. Secret technique, choose a skill from your draw pile and place it into your hand. And deep breath, shuffle your discard pile into your draw pile. And gain a card. So, what would be more useful? If I can channel a frost, it's also defense. And that will actually draw a card. So let's get that one. And an orb. Thank you for watching, and I hope to see you in the next one. Bye.